I was just greatly competing because so the country has launched a three-stage program since very beginning. In 1948, Atomic Energy Commission was constituted just 1 year after the independence, and the Atomic Energy Commission in India is interested to frame the policies in respect of harnessing the atomic energy in the country. In order to execute the policies framed up by the Atomic Energy Commission, Department of Atomic Energy was constituted in 1954. Department of Atomic Energy has 63 organizations, and my company, Nuclear Power Corporation, is one among 63. Let me just tell you. When I talk about this company, this is the only company, Nuclear Power Corporation, which is responsible for design, construction, commissioning, operation and maintenance and decommissioning of the nuclear power plants. This company is AAA, making profit in four figures. To give you an idea, the maximum profit at any point of time which we have made was 2,660 crores 3 years back. Right now, last year it was again in four figures. So to give in the US dollars, the company's reserves and the surplus as on date, Nuclear Power Corporation company's, you know, financial position when we see, and we have, you know, without importing the reactors, with our own domestic program, selling the electricity at cheap rate, that is what we have accumulated, is over 12,000 crores. And in terms of dollars, for my friends from Russia, to just give them an idea, the Nuclear Power Corporation reserves and surplus in terms of dollar are $250 million. Right. We are above numbers. Huh? Right? We don't take any government budgetary support for last 3 years. We have not opted for it because the powers which are given to the NPCIL board are higher than numbers. So therefore we did not, it was not useful. Right? So this is the kind of state of affairs, and the nuclear technology in this country has already been commercially launched. 17 reactors are operating, of which two reactors, Tarapur 1 and 2, have been supplied by US. All of you know that in 1969, the first ever reactor which the India installed was from US, and it has been operating. It has given a service life of 40 years. And you know, you will be amazed to see that's the only non-hydroelectric source which is supplying electricity at a rate of 94 paisa even today. Yesterday's rate was 93.5 paisa per kilowatt hour. That's the only source, right? And we would see when we talk of the economics of the nuclear reactor, yes, upfront cost of the nuclear power plants are higher because of the safety and so several other factors, but the tariffs, they are even lower than the coal-based power plant, 800 kilometers away from the pit heads. And maybe near pit head, they are comparable. We are also trying to make some efforts, you know, to reduce it. How we are going to do it, let's first see. So, we must all be proud of that, that our country is very much robust in the nuclear power program. We are a developing country, that is said, but I would just tell you, it is a developed country in respect of the nuclear power. It has now been, you know, accepted world over. You all have been reading the news, and that's the reason, you know, 1, 2, 3 civilian nuclear cooperation. So it's not a really a help or any kind of, you know, trap or any other thing, that civil nuclear cooperation. I am not trying to sell my idea, I am just telling you one important thing is the need of the hour, and it is the recognition of our strength. We are 1.1 billion population. You know what is our biggest strength? 50% of the population is less than, you know, 25 years of age. The highly bubbling, enthusiastic young people available, and the kind of qualified manpower, the capital, human capital asset which the India possesses, I think that may be one of the biggest thing which we would be proud of. So it's blessings in disguise. So all these things, and plus environmental concerns, and also in spite of the sanctions on India after Pokhran 1 and Pokhran 2, we have produced reactors. As a matter of fact, the nuclear power developed more after 1998. So that's one reason, that because we are going ahead with this famous three-stage nuclear power program, and that recognition has come, we all must be very much proud of it. So the Indian nuclear power program consists of three stages. Stage 1, which is very popularly known as pressurized heavy water reactors. Actually, they use natural uranium, and heavy water as their moderator and cooler. There are 15 such reactors which are operating out of 17 reactors. I said 15 are PS approvals. And the biggest capacity reactor which India has made very recently is Tarapur 3 and 4, which is pride of Maharashtra, we can say pride of the country. The reason is that the reactors has been completed in less than 5 years of time period and in less than the approved budget, and they have straight away gone to the 90%, 96% and above availability factors, and they have registered a very good, you know, performance. So this is first stage program which has been realized. Now another thing is people are concerned about the waste. Some subjects are safety and waste. So here I would like to tell you this three stage program which India has conceived, developed and implemented very successfully is a closed fuel cycle concept. There is no waste in this program. The first stage fuel, which is natural uranium, when it does its service, it is called as a spent fuel. And this spent fuel is highly radioactive. And in other countries, they are going through once through cycle. That means they will use this uranium, make it highly radioactive and store it. We don't do it because it is blessings in disguise again for us, and the thanks to the policy makers and the visionaries who decided that this spent fuel of the first stage will be acting as a fuel for the second stage, that is fossil fuel. So what happens, the natural uranium gets converted into, natural uranium is having two isotopes. For those who are, you know, non-scientific background, or maybe, so I would try to simplify. Uranium is an element, as we get some element like carbon is an element, it's a heavy element. It has two isotopes, three isotopes, predominantly two isotopes, uranium-235 and uranium-238. This is the mass. Uranium-235 is, out of the 1 kg, 1000 grams, uranium-235 is 7 gram. 993 gram is uranium-238. This 7 gram is useful in the first stage. This stage, 7 gram is important. So, when the fuel is loaded, only 2 to 3 gram of uranium-235, out of the 7 gram is only consumed. And remaining 3-4 gram remain there in the fuel itself. It doesn't get consumed. Only hardly 1% of the fuel is consumed. And 2 to 3 gram is converted into plutonium-239. And plutonium-239 is that material which is strategic. Either you can use for peaceful purposes or strategic purposes. And that is where the inspections and the reprocessing, reservations on reprocessing and other things have been, you know, asked time and again. Because if we are buying the reactor from outside, buying the fuel, they would like to have that this plutonium accounting has to be pakka, so that we have not used it in the other applications, which are non-peaceful kind of thing, you know. That's what the, but now everything has been agreed, that reprocessing has been agreed, and the things are going on, and procedures are being worked out. So first stage, 15 reactors, and 10,000 we can go with this. The second stage will use the spent fuel of this in FBRs. FBR already on commercial launch, and it will be operational by 2010 or early 2011. It is 500 megawatt. We have a very ambitious plan of launching 4 more FBRs and then many more FBRs. So, and in this reactor only the thorium will be loaded at a later date. You know, plutonium will be acting like uranium-235. It will produce the power, and uranium-238, which is obtained from this stage, will get converted into plutonium. You know, plutonium is produced, precursor for production of plutonium is uranium-238. And uranium-238 is very high, 993 I said, and out of that we got converted, so 990 gram is available out of the kg fuel which I loaded here. So, this plutonium will be sufficiently built up, and then FBR would be going. And then we would be loading thorium in the blanket. Thorium converts into another fissile, you know, element, that is called as uranium-233, just like uranium-239. Now what is happening is, in this, the India is very rich in the thorium. India has also developed the thorium technologies, but then many people ask the question, why thorium is not being utilized? It will take some time. I will just tell you, the entire program is sequential. A country cannot wait for my, you know, all developments and commercial launching. So from first stage to second to third, it could take few decades. You know, so the kind of growth which the country has registered, the kind of aspiration of the society, the kind of our commitments, the targets are there to see that power to all has to be met. So therefore, there has to be an immediate, you know, attention given to this area of electricity, and we are going for that. So this I have said, it is a sequential program, it will take time, that's why. But then only thing is, what country can be proud of, or the biggest strength of my country is that I have a program which has been working all right, very fine, it's robust and on course. If deal or no deal, I will go. Only thing is, I will be slower. That's all. If you don't cooperate, okay, fine. I will go with the 3-stage program. If you cooperate, I will go a little faster. That's the kind of thing. So that's how the entire thing. Now, to those who are interested, nuclear power plant size. You know, the one which are shown here are in operation. This blue one is in operation, you know. These are all operating nuclear power plants. So you can see a kind of pattern here. Sorry. You can see a kind of pattern here. All reactors are almost one quad of a circle, right? They are all away from the coal mines, right? This is one. So, for those places like Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat, and maybe in the southernmost part, including Andhra Pradesh, which are, you know, little away from the coal mine, we would prefer the nuclear power station. However, nuclear power stations are location neutral. That means they don't get affected, because the fuel transportation is very, very low. I said a few trucks you can take for 1 year inventory. For one reactor, we need almost 30 tons of the fuel for 220 megawatt. So I can always, a lorry of having 30 ton capacity can always transport for 1 year. So the transportation cost is almost negligible. Even the fuel cost itself is negligible in the tariff that we would see. So gentlemen, you can see here, and the gentle ladies, both. You can just see here that the nuclear power plants which are in operation are shown here by this. There are 4 reactors in Rajasthan. Rajasthan unit 1, 2, 3 and 4, 220 megawatt. And unit 5 and 6, they are ready for operation. Maybe by the year end, you will see 3 reactors of 220 megawatt are under operation, and the 4th reactor of 1000 megawatt, which is with the Russian collaboration being constructed near Kanyakumari, is also operational by the end of this year. So you would see that 4 reactors are going, you know, operational during this year. The other one here, you can see these are under construction. Right now, the nuclear power capacity, as Mr. Balram Murthy must have informed you yesterday, while discussing with him, he said 4,120 is the megawatt, is the installed capacity. 3,160 is under construction. So by the end of the 11th five-year plan, I am going to realize. We have met the commitment in 10th five-year plan. We were given a target of 82 billion units production, we produced 90. We were given a target of addition of 1,400 megawatt, we did it. And we were given a target to reduce the tariff, we have done it. Right? So all the targets of the government has been met, and I again assure you that all the targets will be met in 11th five-year plan also. Barring for the, you know, generation which may be slipping some few percentages because of the things which are happening in the fuel constraints. Otherwise all other targets are being met. Jatapur, 2 units of French region, they are already in offing, we are in discussion. It is in Maharashtra. And then we are also having Taiga Uttarakhand. I was talking to Principal Secretary, who is here during the tea time. I informed him that there is a request from the ministers, or maybe the Chief Minister level, to us. Just before coming here, a letter had come to us that we would like to have more nuclear power plants. The request has come from Andhra Pradesh. We have worked out certain details. Request has come from many states. Actually, that is a kind of public acceptability and support to the nuclear power, which is building up over a period of time. Maybe because now people have gained more confidence, and we have been discussing very transparently about all the issues, and more exposure has been given. So you can see here, Kalpakkam in Chennai, we are constructing fast breeder reactor. We are Kundanpuram, Tirunelveli district, we are having 2 Russian plants, you know, with the cooperation with the Russia, 2000 megawatt installed capacity, which is in advanced stage, 2 units. And 2 units are already approved by the government. In principle, approval is there. Now, what are the future plans? So I said 3,100. You can see this figure. This the country will be getting in another 1.5 years by the end of 11th plan. Certainly, 11th five-year plan proposals. The start of work on 8 indigenous pressurized heavy water reactors of 700 megawatt. We have demonstrated Tarapur 3 and 4. 540 in less than 5 years, and the entire cost per megawatt had been registered was around 5.2 crore per megawatt. 5,572 crore crores is spent against a budget approval of roughly around 6,000 plus. So now the question is, we have saved the money, we have saved the time, and the tariffs are very good, attractive plants are most modern, and the entire technique is there. So we upgraded the design to scale up 500 megawatt, 540 megawatt to 700, to see that we get an economy of scaling up in the capacity. We would also be starting work on 10 light water reactors of 1000 megawatt, essentially the imported reactors. Pre-project activities on two more fast feeder reactors would be taken up during this 11th year. Now this is to give you a flavor that July 18, 2005 was the date when we took first decision, the country took the first decision to issue a joint statement by India and USA on enabling full civil nuclear cooperation. Since then we have gone quite ahead. Just to give you a flavor, one more is to be added here, 18 type of agreement with different countries has been there. So this civil nuclear agreement doesn't mean business between US and the India. Let it be very, very clear. It is equal opportunity and a global kind of thing would be there. There will be many countries including Russia, French, US and other countries, those who are there. Kazakhstan, we have already entered with one MOU, they would be giving fuel. And Areva company, we have entered in a MOU, fuel has already come, right? Part of the fuel, this thing under the status. Now, just to give you a flavor, because time doesn't permit, it's lunch time to be there. So I will just tell you, we are here, 4,100, we will be here, 7,280, and then it will continue like this, and then we would be here. If there is no international cooperation, that means business as usual, three stage program, our own program, and Swadeshi program. If that goes on, I will be 15,000 by the year 2020. If international civil nuclear cooperation is effective as it is being in a very, very positive manner, we would be 25,000 and maybe 40,000. It depends on the development in the international cooperation. But I can tell you the developments have been very, very positive. The response from all the countries world over has been extremely positive, and we are going in a big way. And I can only share with you that the nuclear power is going to play an important role, not only supplying power to the country at a cheaper rate, but also to ensure that there is a decarbonization of the atmosphere. So these are some of the subjects I have touched. I will only talk of the waste management. I said there is no waste generated in our plants because we are the people who recycle. The waste in form of spent fuel, which is obtained from the first stage, will be used as the fuel for the second stage after reprocessing. So therefore there are no major waste. Right? And then the second stage is spent fuel will be used in the third stage. So essentially it is a closed fuel cycle. So there is no question of comparing the waste generated in the Western countries and in our own country. And to that effect we are fully geared up. You will be pleased to know that all pre-processing facilities are in operation and we are flexible enough, right from front end to the back end of the technology. The safety, we have registered 293 years, reactor years of experience without any incident or any accident. As a matter of fact, world over 13,000 reactor years of experience has been registered. And there has been only two accidents which have been, and one among them, Chernobyl, had been, in Russia, which has been in wide discussion. And the reasons for the Chernobyl have already been, found out. It is just because the reactor was different, it did not have the containment. It was a graphite cooled reactor which catches fire. There were operator errors. Lots of things were done, and since then those kind of reactors are not in, much operation. They are not being operated, and there is a large number of improvement done even in Russia for those. We do not want to go into the details. But in our kind of reactors, one good characteristic is there, or even in PWR, as the temperature goes high, suppose something happens, power goes very high, it becomes uncontrolled. As the moment it goes to a certain level of temperature, power will start reducing. This is called as an inherent safety feature. That means whether a man or no man, person or no person, operator or no operator, the reactor will take its own course and the braking action will start. This is the inherent, And then we have multiple barriers. Before the radioactivity can be released, there are five barriers which has to be crossed. The fuel itself, which is fabricated and supplied by our NFC, which is here in Hyderabad, it's a ceramic fuel and it can sustain very high temperature of the order of 2800 degrees C to 3000 degrees, even higher. And then all fission products are retained here. then there is a casing here, what we call it as a fuel cladding, that is a barrier, the entire fuel is encapsulated into a cover which is deployed, and then there is a channel in which the fuel is there. So what I mean to say, there are five barriers. Time doesn't permit, otherwise I would have explained you that it's easier said than getting experience that the radioactivity release will take place, because we have to understand that how many barriers are there. So you can see here person is there, all these barriers are shown here. Radiation dose, when you see, actually the limit of the Atomic Energy Regulatory Board itself is quite high. It's quite low as compared to the world limits, which are higher. We are very conservative in fixing the limit, and you can see immeasurable doses. We are not able to measure the dose. Now, if I give a simply Eiffel Tower height, which is 300 meter, is the life-threatening dose. Then what people can get the dose? It is only property I am just telling you is equal to the thickness of the bridge. So you can see, if life-threatening dose is here, 300 meters, thickness of the bridge, that is a possibility. And what actually is there in nuclear power plant, the radiation which has been measured over 50 years in the India, just before the start of the plant, we measure the radiation, natural radiation, which we call it as a background radiation. And after the operation of the plant, just like Shadi se pehle Shadi ke baad, no difference. This is what waste management, we have closed fuel cycle, I said. So, and waste management. Now, let's come to the money part. I said that the Tarapur power plant unit number 1 and 2, which is 40 years old, is supplying at a rate of 94 paisa per kilowatt hour. Per kilowatt hour, when I say the one unit which you consume and you pay. So, it is 94 paisa. Our all 17 plants, last 3 year tariffs are here. 232 in the year 2005-06. 219 paisa, that is rupees 219 paisa in 228 paisa. Small variations are there because new plant comes up, so slightly it may go up because of the depreciation and other thing. But you can see that all the tariff which we are supplying the Jupiter power is much lower. Now, let's see how does it compare with this. There is a plant in a place called as Narada Atomic Power Plant, which is near Bulandshahr, or you can say near Delhi, 120 kilometers from Delhi. And Bulandshahr is a place in Uttar Pradesh, which is 60 kilometers away. And Bulandshahr and Dadri, they are close by. There is a thermal power plant and there is an atomic plant. The Narora plant is supplying at a rate of 1 rupee and 91 paisa. If fuel adjustment goes on, and actually it may be 190, sometime 192, but then it will be of this order. These are all notified, And Dadri plant is giving 3 rupees and 36 paisa. So you can compare the economics. Yes.
Is there any subsidy element for the capital cost?
There is no subsidy, there is no budgetary support.
All the capital costs?
Yes, ma'am. We can discuss outside. I will give you the actual figures and you can quote it. I will sign it. Right? I am so sure about it. So now the tariffs of other non-pit-headed station. Badarpur Thermal Power Station in Delhi. Those of you who are from Delhi would be knowing Badarpur is quite famous because it supplies electricity. But then it charges you rupees 37 paisa. Right? Whereas Firoz Gandhi, Uchaha Thermal Power Plant, another one charges 2 rupees. Right? So you can compare with Narora. Right? These are all non-pit head. Now some more data is given. Now I compared all the plants, all over. Just few minutes, I know that lunch is there, I am taking some more time, but this is, right? So, I would just like to tell you, you can say our Kakarpur plant in Surat, near Surat, in Gujarat, is supplying at 2 rupees. And then you can say Nasik, 251, Tarapur 1 and 2, I said 94 paisa, you see here. Tarapur 3, 4, 2, 283, this is the most new plant, latest plant. And over a period of time, its tariff will also reduce, just like Tarapur, 94. Because I will tell you why. Initially, we are executing our all projects with 70% of borrowings and 30% of our equity. 70% borrowings, they bear the interest. And that interest is paid in 8-9 years installments. So for 8-9 years, it would be 2 rupees 80 paisa. But after that, it would again drop to 1 rupee or something like this. So, and the nuclear power plant life is now 60 years. So, once you have built them, उसको वो बोलते हैं ना दादा बनाएगा और पोता बनेगा That means if they are charging 3 rupees, 2 rupees and 40 paisa is towards the charges of the fuel, coal. The capacity charges, the fixed charges are only 60 paisa. In case of nuclear, the capacity charges are high, which are recovered. When I have recovered depreciation and all those things after few years, then the fuel charges are minimal. So the cost of the supply of the electricity or the generation comes down drastically. But then initially you can see the kind of tariff structure which I have shown you, we are not having very high, right, for the new plant. Yes, yes, I have 2 minutes, I know. Now, this is of your interest. There is a project which you are executing, the Russian friends are executing, which is Udangulam 1 and 2, 1000 megawatt. It is at an approved cost of 13,171 crore. To give you an idea, that 6.5 crore per megawatt, light water, this is what we are executing. And the cost of our plant will be 5.4 crores per megawatt at 2008 prices, 700 megawatt. Pardon? Tariff will be 1 rupee 99 paisa from Kundankulam, less than 2 rupees as on date. Conclusion is not a boasting. Nuclear is supplementing. It will continue to supplement for some more time, but it will supplement in a much more, you know, systematic, orderly, and much more humanly fashion, right? Nuclear power is safe, clean, environment friendly, as you have seen, and economically competitive. Nuclear power is most potent means, because I can multiply, I can go for 2000 years, 5000 years, right, when I go for the close cycle. Only thing is, because country could not wait, and there were certain strategic decisions which has been taken, and all policy makers, they have, and the people, media, everybody has put a lot of faith. And then we have gone in for the civil information. Thank you very much. Participating in that, India is one among them. India will manufacture equipment and supply to for that project in France. Right? India is a supplier for that. Right? Number one. This project name is International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactors. It is called as ITER of light nuclei, just like it is happening in sun. Right? And the temperature which will be encountered would be of the order of 1,000,000 degrees C. So that is why the biggest challenge is no material is available, everything will melt. So they are developing a very good material, and India is incidentally in metallurgy doing a very good job. Right?
We are
so
participating.
We are participating in a big way. Our share is that 2000 crore order they have already given to us. You know, another thing I would just like to share here with the distinguished audience is, when we talk of the civil nuclear cooperation, it is not one way that I will take. Right? Just before coming here, I cannot declare here from the podium, I myself have made a very big proposal to one of the countries for, you know, exporting of nuclear reactors of a small and medium size. We would also be supplying the nuclear reactor and component. And one good example is that this ITER decision, we also have to exploit the opportunity.
Lots of misconceptions are there among the people. Perhaps I don't know kind of dedication, right?
It's our fault because we were never so transparent. You know, I am talking heart to heart to you. Right? This thing we have started last few years, and atomic energy was a black box for the people. Neither we thought that it is required nor the people demanded. So now both the parties have understood, and there is a very good kind of, you know, this.